Well, at first glance, you know, you might think this is a Windows system. You know, sure seems like a Windows system. We got Peer Guardian and AVG Antivirus and Volver, and there's Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, and Computer Network and all that. And, you know, we click on the start menu here, and, well, sure seems to look Windowsy enough, you know, and all that. And we go into the computer and sorry if the video's freaking out here. I don't know what's happening. Come on, knock it off. That is odd. It's like freaking out a little bit. Weird. Okay, anyway. You can kind of see here. It does appear at first glance to be a Windows machine. Yep. Sure does appear that way. But you know what the old saying is, right? The old saying is that looks can be deceiving. This is in fact a Linux system. Doesn't seem to be freaking out now that I'm back on the Linux machine. I guess my camcorder doesn't like Windows. But who does? Anyway, yeah, you can see this is Ubuntu Linux, more specifically Linux Mint. So, gee, how the heck did I just do that? This little application called Sun VirtualBox. Check it out. Windows XP Media Center and all this stuff here. And it is a virtual machine. It is a fake computer. It is something that, you know, you install to Linux. It's a program and, you know, pretends to be a computer, and they'll let you run any OS within any other OS. So, guess what else that means? That means if you're a Windows user and you've been wanting to try Linux, and you've just been kind of afraid to for whatever reason, that means that you can just go ahead and do that. You can go to virtualbox.org, and you can download and install VirtualBox, and can install Linux into it as a virtual machine if you're running on Windows. And if you're running on Linux and you've got your Windows disk, then you can install Windows as a virtual machine like I did. And you're also able to save snapshots. It's almost like saving a list of system restore points in a way, so that something messes up, you can put it back to the way it was before. So yeah, it's pretty cool. So if, you know, you really want to run Linux as your core operating system, you know, so you can do your web browsing and all that good stuff uninhibited and no worries about getting spyware and whatever. But, you know, you got these games that maybe the software called Play on Linux doesn't support your game yet. Maybe Wine doesn't support your game yet. Maybe Crossover doesn't support your game yet. Maybe you just don't have the money to subscribe to Sudoku. Now it's no problem. You can take any version of Windows that you have, whatever it is that you seem to enjoy using as far as that. Keep it as far away from the internet as possible. Just limit it to those specialized tasks of yours. And you can just run that shit as a virtual machine. So let's go back in right quick before we end the vid. I'm going to click in, I'm going to hit the Control F again for the full screen, there we go, and you could just switch back and forth. It's real easy. You just you hit the Control F to take it out of full screen, Control Home to give mouse control and everything back to Linux, and you can just minimize it and, you know, do whatever. You could have it loaded while you're doing stuff on Linux, and you're also doing stuff in Windows, and you just kind of flip back and forth, or keep it unloaded until you're ready for it, and, you know, shut it down when you're done with it, whatever you want to do. So, yeah, it's pretty neat stuff, so you should go over to virtualbox.org, and you should check that out. Alrighty. Cool.